り上がり。
わーい。いただきます。
Hey guys, today we'll be making Bonbon's fried rice from One Piece. In this rice, they used a special salt, the salt from Aqua Laguna, which originates from All Blue. This is what gave this dish its amazing flavor, and I think I found the real-life equivalent of that. If you're interested, stick around to find out, and without further ado, let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is make some rice. For fried rice, I think the best way to make rice is using a rice cooker. So, we'll start by adding 3 cups of rice. We'll then rinse the rice under cold water until the water turns cloudy like this. Once that happens, pour the water away and rinse it again. Do this a few times until the water is clear like this. Now, pour the washed rice into the rice cooker and add equal amounts of water to the rice. In this case, 3 cups. Add bay leaves and then let the rice cooker do its job. After about 25 minutes, my rice was done. It's a well-known fact that using leftover rice results in the best fried rice. So, I'll let mine cool in the fridge so that we can use it later. In the meantime, let's make the salt, which makes this dish so special. In the anime, Sanji states that the salt used is a byproduct of Aqua Laguna. The reason why it has such a peculiar taste is because of the minerals from All Blue. I think that the closest thing we have in real life to that is Persian Blue Salt. Persian Blue Salt is one of the rarest salts in the world, found in the mountain ranges of Iran. It was formed from an ancient sea which dried about 100 million years ago and has stayed isolated all this time. The blue color is a side effect of the structures being compact and resulting in an optical illusion where blue light is refracted. The blue salt is quite coarse, so I'll make it finer with a pestle and mortar. However, I think we're missing something to make it like the salt from All Blue, and that thing is MSG. I think that due to the high pressures of the Aqua Laguna, combined with the sea life and seaweed, there is some levels of MSG in the Aqua Laguna salt, hence the strong flavor that Sanji mentioned. That's why I combined 3 tablespoons of the salt with 2 tablespoons of the MSG to achieve that intense taste. Now that we have our salt, we can prepare the rest of the ingredients. First, we'll start by cutting some spring onions. Then, separate the white parts from the green ends. We'll also cut a red bell pepper. I first cut out the core, then I diced it into 1-inch pieces like this. Now, turn up the heat. Add some cooking oil to a wok. Once the oil is about as hot as me, then add the red bell peppers and the white parts of the green onions. This is to give them a head start cooking. After about a minute, get the vegetables out of the oil into a different plate. After that, we can start bringing the whole dish together. Add oil again and bring it to a high heat. Then, crack an egg into the oil. Scramble the eggs. Then, add the green onions. Add the rice and mix it up so it doesn't clump up. Then, add the cooked veggies. Keep the rice moving so that you can give it some of that wok hay. Add a tablespoon of the All Blue salt to the fried rice. Add some soy sauce around the edges and mix up the rice. And now, add a teaspoon of sesame oil and 2 teaspoons of sugar to balance out all the flavors. Mix it up for the last time, and with that, the all blue fried rice from One Piece should be done. Now, it's time to plate. So yeah, that's it. The all blue fried rice from One Piece. This tasted really amazing. The way that a good fried rice should be. It was well balanced, and each individual rice grain was dancing in my mouth in harmony with the vegetables, all being bound together by the flavors of the wok hei and umami. I really can't recommend this dish enough, and I hope you guys will try it. And as always, thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe, and have a nice day.